There's no question that religious life in the contemporary Northern Hemisphere, in the United States of America, in Europe, is a countercultural decision. It does cut against the grain of the ambient relativism or confusion about ultimate meaning, and against the grain also of the comforts of materialism and of the idea that we can just manage our lives in this world and try to get through and not venture into territories that are too experimental or lose our way in extreme forms of sacrifice. That kind of materialistic caution or prudence that's worldly. At the same time, there's a kind of miserable asceticism to the modern secular world in the sense that it has its own severity where you are not allowed to become haunted by deep questions or worry about your relationship with the transcendent God in such a way that could threaten the status quo or the established order. What religious life does is it bursts through that convention. It breaks ranks. It teaches people that actually we are meant to live for what's ultimate. We are meant to ask big questions, be vulnerable to them, and allow the mystery of God to change our lives radically. In fact, we dress in a different way, partly to denote that our entire body and soul can be changed by God, by the reality of the resurrection, that we can encounter Christ. There's a beautiful little book, spiritual book, written by a Carmelite saint of the 20th century, Elizabeth of the Trinity, and she wrote a beautiful little book just simply entitled, I Found God. And when you see a religious on the street, one possible reaction is to say, that person found God. Or that person was found by God. And that raises the question of whether I could find God, or I could be found by God, even in the midst of the secular wilderness, even in the midst of the confusion, or the distractions, so many tangible distractions that surround us in our exteriorized world. Religious lead a countercultural life of interiority, study, service, charity, penance, adoration, contemplation, love of Christ that's unconditional, desire to surrender their life to God, holy obedience, hope in divine providence, and steady work for the kingdom of God in the service of the church, with all their imperfections. But in doing so, they manifest a new possibility in light of Christ, that we could give our life unconditionally to God. And in that sense, they are a very important witness in the midst of our world today that there's a higher alternative. And we need them. We need them because we need what they suggest, which is that we can be saved by God.